Hello everyone, and welcome to another Cornix tutorial. In this video, I will provide you with an overview of the trading configuration. The trading configuration will allow you to modify the default settings that will be used when Cornix creates trades automatically on your behalf. Your selected trading configuration will have a significant impact on your trading results and your trade's behavior, so we highly recommend watching this video till the end. Before actually diving into the configuration and starting to modify the parameters yourself, I highly recommend going over more in-depth explanations on each specific parameter, which can be found in our knowledge base. And now, let's get started. To access the configuration section in the Telegram bot, start by clicking the bot configuration option in the main menu and proceed to select the trading option. In the next screen, proceed to select a client from the list. Please note that each client can only have one trading configuration. If you wish to have different configurations for each channel that is connected with auto trading to the same client, we suggest using the duplicate client functionality. For more information, please visit the link in the description. In the next screen, you will see the main trading configuration page, which includes an overview of the current client trading configuration. To change the configuration parameters in each section, simply click the button on the bottom that corresponds to the section title. In addition, next to each parameter, you will see the current parameter value, and next to it on the right, the current override value. The override mechanism will allow you to choose which configuration between your personal configuration and the signal configuration will take priority when trades are created on your behalf using auto trading and one-click follow. For more information about the override mechanism, please watch the next YouTube tutorial or visit the article in the description. Let's proceed and go over each of the different configuration options. As I mentioned, in this video, I will only briefly go over each of the configuration sections. For an in-depth explanation of each configuration parameter, please visit the configuration section in our knowledge base using the link in the description. The Import Configuration section will allow you to import a configuration that was exported by admins in the groups you are subscribed to. This configuration will override your personal configuration and will allow you to easily set up your configuration based on channel admins' recommendations. In the General section, you will be able to set the Amount per Trade parameter, which will determine the default amount that will be used for every trade that is created for you automatically or using the one-click follow. The Close Trade on Take Profit Before Entry parameter, as the name suggests, will allow you to choose whether or not you want your automated trades to close when a take profit target is reached before any of the entry targets. The Trailing section will allow you to set the default trailing entry, trailing take profit, and trailing stop values. For trailing entry and take profit, you will be able to select the trailing percentage, while for trailing stop, you will be able to choose between several different trailing stop types. The Strategies section will let you choose your entry and take profit strategies. Your selected strategy will determine the percentage of the trade amount that will be bought or sold in each entry or take profit target. For your convenience, Cornix offers a variety of different strategies by default, and you will also be able to create custom entry and take profit strategies. In some cases, a signal might be posted with an entry zone instead of specific entry targets. For that reason, the Strategies section will also let you set your default number of targets to be used when a signal contains an entry zone instead of targets with specific prices. In the Stop Loss section, you will be able to set the default percentage below the weighted average entry price to place a stop. This will allow you to always make sure your trades are created with a stop, even if the original signal did not contain one. In addition, this section will let you choose the stop limit price reduction parameter, which will determine the percent difference between the stop price and the limit price when using limit stop loss. Lastly, for some exchanges, you will also be able to configure the default stop type that will be used for all your stop loss orders between a limit stop loss and a market stop loss. The Auto Trading Filters section will allow you to define a set of rules based on which Cornix will filter out signals and prevent automatic trades from being created in your account. For example, you will be able to filter out signals with specific symbols or pairs, or signals where the symbol price is lower than a certain threshold. Lastly, the margin section will only be visible when the selected client is connected to an exchange that supports margin or futures trading. This section will allow you to select the default leverage and to enable or disable the automated creation of long and short trades. Please make sure to visit our knowledge base for in-depth explanations about each of the different configuration parameters. This is it for this video. I will see you next time.